So let's look at creating a sill for this window. So I'm going to just jump to the drawing right away. It's already set up. So I'm just going to click on the exterior. And we'll come down here and we'll just draw a an extrusion. I'm going to come in and just reform it for now. So we want the let's say the depth of the sill to be 6 inches. And it's a little out of scale visual. Well, actually, I did that a poor way. What I really wanted to do was to pull this up to the bottom of the window and highlight that line and do 6 inches. And we'll go ahead and complete that off. And we'll look at that for the left side view. And it's on the wrong side of the, but that's all right. We can just flip this around here, I think. All right, so we have the start at -3. And we have a 12-inch wall, so actually what we need is something over 6 inches. So we need 6.25. And this is where we're not getting an accurate representation of our components because we're not using the right wall size. But that's really not all that important at this point. Just want you to get a feeling for how we could add a component in. Let's give that the same trim color. And I made it 6.25 or 6.25 so that it just slightly overextends the exterior of the wall. Let's go ahead and see what that looks like. And we're going to overwrite it. And there we have our sill. And it's sticking out a little bit. We could make that more or less proud depending on how we wanted to. And I think one of the other important things is to actually rotate it this way. And we're getting a little bit of interference with the texture at the bottom of the window. So that's something we might want to correct. So if we were to go over here to the left view, we actually might want to pull this up just a little bit, just so that it's not interfering with the return wall texture. All right, so that'll take care of that, and I can show you how that's going to change that. So we'll go back to that same view again and overwrite it. And now that whole surface is clean along there. Now there could be a lot done to this. This could have trim in it so that it drained naturally. It could be built on an angle. There's all kinds of ways this shape could extend over into the brick for a little bit of a bite. But let's go ahead and look at what we could do up at the top, just to get an idea of what our flexibilities are here with this. So I'm going to go back to the window again, to the exterior, and we're going to make a little lintel for the top. So we're going to go to extrusion, and this time I'm going to work with the line tool. I'll come in and I'll just make a line, maybe at 105 degrees, and it will come out 8 inches. I want exactly the same thing on the other side, so I'm going to use my mirror tool. And now we just have to complete off the shape. And we'll go to the left view so we can see what dimensions we might want to adjust here. So once again, we want this to come out proud of the window. So we'll be at -6.25 again. And we still have that issue about wanting to not show any of the brick underneath. So I'm just going to pull that down a tad. I could be really, it just needs to be a little bit in front of that. And let's give it the same trim color. Load that in and overwrite. All right, and there we have our little window study about how we might want to modify the appearance of our window in a frame. There's a couple of things. Well, let's just change our rendering. Let's get rid of the lines because I think they're all, I always think they're a bit distracting. So we'll turn those edges. We'll smooth it off a little bit. We'll throw these ambient shadows in, see if that does anything. And then also, let's add a little sky, see if we can get some. All right, and then I'll just one last pass on this. So this is basically no way to do a window detail in a brick, because what we do is be capturing water behind between the brick and the trim component. Really have no way of waterproofing it. This would be a preferred way. This is the same window with the trim off and then sitting it back. And then when we get to the idea of a full-blown custom window, we're really trying to match the original character of this style of window, this deep inset and exposure of the brick, and we can control that with this where we place the window in the system. And then the addition of the lintel and the sill trims that could be in stone. All of these add up to enhance the overall beauty of a brick wall surface. So that's our overview to that. Then next we'll look at taking our window that we've constructed and inserting it into a brick facade, more complex wall facade.